What is going on, everybody? Welcome back once again. My name is Jordan, also known as J Monster, and you're watching another episode of 4th Age Total War, a wonderful modification for Rome 1 Total War Barbarian Invasion. And, we're playing as the Elven Kingdom, so we have a couple of interesting choices here. We have managed to get Glorfindel and his army to our southern front, which you can see the cultists of Adunabar here are poised to overrun. So we have a couple of options. I think we can attack this army here under Lieutenant Findigil. And we've got another force here under Telhumatar of Southern Ithilien, and I think we're going to go for that one. Because that is it's a general, so it's a lot more important than just some regular captain. And there's also another much larger army coming down here that we're going to have to deal with. So I prefer not to have to fight two generals together, which looks like maybe that's kind of going to be what we have to do. That's fine. Let's take them on. I'm sure Glorfindel could probably slaughter all of them on his own anyway. A lot of infantry, which means that they won't be moving terribly fast. That's good. So we can isolate this one force here under Telhumatar and destroy them quickly. We shouldn't have too many issues winning the battle. So I will see you guys on the battle map. Oh great, it's a bloody forest battle. Well, let's try and fight out here. That would be preferable. I really can't see anything that happens in forest battles in the first Rome Total War. They don't have that neat little ping feature that shows you where all of your armies or all of your units are at all times. That Medieval 2 has. Let's stick our Noldor on the left, backed up by our Elven Swords. Nice flank crushing force right here. We're also going to stack Glorfindel on the other side. The nice little balanced deployment. And we'll stick our Mounted Archers there. That's fine. Everyone but you two, group one. And you can just do your own thing. Okay, so the Adunabar cultists, they're probably not going to. I think they're probably up on this hill, yeah. Yeah, they are. So they're probably not going to come to us, I wouldn't think. Might be able to set up right here and harass them as they come in with our archers. In the meantime, let's stick our mounted cav over here in the forest. Try and hide them from our enemy, and we'll move Glorfindel and his warriors into a frontal assault. Because why not? This is what Glorfindel is good for. So yeah, we've got some pathetic orc infantry right there. Yeah, we're gonna run right over these guys. It's gonna be no problem. Charge! For Valinor! I don't know what Glorfindel sounds like an old man. He is pretty old, though. I mean, if you guys don't know who Glorfindel is, he's actually a really cool character. And it's not entirely clear if the Glorfindel from Fellowship of the Ring, who saves Frodo from the ring wraiths by driving them into the river, it's not clear if he's the same Glorfindel from the First Age who took on a Balrog after the Siege of Gondolin. That's the name of the city. After the Siege of Gondolin was lost, the refugees from that city fled into the hills, and there was a secret pass there, but unfortunately they had been sold out by Maeglin the Dark Elf. I think we mentioned him in one of our earlier videos. They'd been sold out by Maeglin, and there was a Balrog with a detachment who had been sent to watch this area. So Glorfindel took him on his own for the sake of the refugees, and there goes their general. That was fast. And he beat this Balrog in single combat, one of the few people to ever do so, I think aside from Gandalf and the captain of the Gondolin City Guard. No one else has ever really managed to accomplish that. Let's destroy these Adunabar nobles. Oh yeah. Yeah, speaking of Gondolin, I can't remember the name of the captain, but he was the captain of the king's household guard, and during the siege, Gothmog, the lord of Balrogs, who was responsible for the deaths of at least two Noldor High Kings, maybe a third, I can't quite remember. But he killed him by ramming the spike on his helmet into his chest and pushed him into a fountain, and then they both fell in together and drowned. Like, must have been a hell of a fountain for one in order to quench the fire of a Balrog and drown the two of them. But, damn. Going out like a boss. So this Glorfindel, whoever he may be, has big shoes to fill. Let's move these guys. Move them forward just a little bit. Glorfindel just eating a large portion of this army. Got some orc raiders down here. I'm gonna kill them as well. These orc raiders are fleeing. We're gonna charge down into the backs of them. Ooh, okay, forgot to turn that off again. God damn it. So much for that charge. Snaga hunters. Yeah, they're even shooting at us? Yeah, they are. That's okay. We're going to start to pour some fire into them with our elven archers. Yeah, you can see it already starting to go in. That cultist reinforcement army is going to be here soon, though. I want to know where they are. Oh, yeah, we have an opportunity here. They don't see our swordsmen. Let's throw the Noldor into battle. Let's take our spears forward as well. Block the advance of these guys. Charge! Yeah, they're poised to overrun us here. Forward, warriors! Where's those damn swords? Ha, there you are. And slip them in behind the enemy lines. I like it. Let's get stuck in. Take those mounted archers, shoot at those orc champions. Let's bring Glorfindel up and around here. Charge him into the teeth of the enemy army. He can probably hold down this entire flank by himself. Yeah, I don't see any cavalry over there. Move, Glorfindel, go! Got some orc band here pressing down on our infantry blob here from the top of that hill. Reverse that by charging into their flank with our own spearmen. Probably sneak these guys through here. Oh, look at this. Elven swords here pushing against these orc raiders. Let's surround these guys. Use our archers here who are now free to do whatever they need to. Let's target those that Dunobar noble bodyguard here. And like I said, Glorfindel holding his own against massive, massive odds. Cutting down these dark swords, and once he's done there, we're going to be able to throw him into the back and the rear of these incoming Orcus troops here. We'll be able to surround that last general and hopefully put these guys into a mass rout. Put an end to this Dunobar invasion for good. I think our next strategic target is going to be that area between, I think, the Emmon Wheel, and Southern Mirkwood. Just on the border there where Amonlank sits, there's a nice little channel that the Dunobar cultists have been using to funnel troops into our lands. I think that's going to be our next target. I want to take that as soon as possible. Let's just surround these guys. At this point, we've won. Come on. Send him after the cavalry. Let's see how our Noldor are doing down here. Very well for themselves. Charging up the hill into surrounding these routing troops here. Look at this. Annihilation! Glorfindel here managed to catch up with their general. Yes, we are going to continue. We want to kill him and his whole bodyguard at the same time. Hey, nice job. Alright, and that is going to be the end of these Dunobar cultists here. Take one last look. Ah, yes. That is glorious. Alright, I will see you guys on the campaign map. Ah, yes. Sorry, forgot again. Don't worry. It's been 3 years since I've been making videos on YouTube, and I still forget to show the casualty screens. I'm so sorry. There you go. Most of the heavy lifting being done by the Noldor Riders and Glorfindel, the man himself. I will see you guys back on the campaign map. Okay, so the cultists have been smashed. Let's see. No more movement points left. We're going to take the Woldburg. Yes, we do have a diplomat right here, so we're going to take that, give it back to Rohan, so we can set up a nice little buffer zone here. And then we're going to go and take the Mid-Deeping. This is a settlement I told you about earlier. You can see how important it is. It's like the key to Southern Mirkwood, essentially. If you want to attack these lands, you've got to come through here. So if we can station Glorfindel and a powerful garrison here at the Mid-Deeping, I think we'll be able to hold our borders against any more Dunobar incursions. Looks like they also have a settlement right here, Lathron. Maybe we'll take that back as well and give that to Rohan, try and get Rohan back on its feet. Look at the Reunited Kingdom actually taking it to the cultists right here. They got a huge army stationed outside Mordor. Otherwise, things are not looking so great for them. Minas Anon, which is what Minas Tirith was renamed to after the Great War of the Ring. Got a pretty decent garrison over here, though. Minas Ithil is going to get taken, unless there's a garrison script in this mod that I don't know about. Yeah, things aren't looking so great for Gondor over here. They need to do something nice with that army. Something strategically nice. Wow, I can't speak today. Alright, let's pass the turn. Oh yes, I forgot about this. Finally managed to get our general to Rivendell. We're going to reoccupy High Pass Stronghold, which is going to put a little bit of a damper on our funds, but it does let us control the only way across the Misty Mountains that I know of. So we've got a lot of strategically important places here, lockdown, which is good for us, good for us logistically. Oh, this is taking forever. I'll see you guys at the end of the next, or at the beginning of the next turn. Oh, never mind. There it is. Alright. Karas Galadon. Making us lots of money. Do I need to build anything else here? Yeah, probably should. Let's see now. Hall of Songs. Feasting Hall. Population growth. Useful. Let's do that. Take the Woldberg. We're actually not gonna fight this. There's like one unit in there. Yeah, no. We're gonna move on with our lives. Occupy. Let's give it back to Rohan. Give province. Down at the bottom. There you go, buddy! Yes, let's be friends. Yes, let us do that. Did I not just give you the friggin' Woldberg? Like, what is this crap? Well, that's confusing. I must have done something wrong. Give province. Yes. Take this right now. There we go. I don't know what I did wrong earlier, but now it's time to move on towards the mid-deeping. I don't know how much longer we're going to have Glorfindel for, and I want to get the most out of him while we still can. We should probably start thinking about maybe moving another general to take control of his army, and maybe just sending him out on, like, mad suicide missions. I don't think we have any more generals, though, to spare at the moment, unfortunately. Haven't gotten too lucky with the whole adoption mechanic in this game. Oh, market. How wonderful. Alliance between the Bjornings and the Kingdom of Rivanion. Not exactly unexpected, but that does raise some problems if we want to take on the Bjornings later in the game. Good to know. Let's take the fight to Argaleb here. Oof. Ooh, that's a big army. It's got a lot of cavalry, too. Hopefully we don't have to fight in a damned forest again. Lieutenant Bregor, looks like he pulled some of the garrison that was in there, so it's about the same amount of troops we would have had to fight anyway. I will see you guys on the battle map. Alright, so we've broken up our army into divisions here. We've got some lighter woodland troops, more lighter woodland troops, and then our heavier troops and our swords underneath Glorfindel. That is a very large force. Oh my goodness. We're going to try and break them up a little bit, though. Yeah, this is our killing power here. This is like our flank smashing group. They have over here. Let's take a look at what we're getting ourselves into first. We got a lot of spears, so we should be able to cut right through them, especially with Glorfindel. We'll engage these two spear units with our swords, and then we'll bring Glorfindel around to smash them to pieces. Fly, you fools! Oh crap. Got a lot of horsemen charging forward. It's not good for us. Alright, get yourselves in the lines. Let's send Glorfindel forward here to kind of start this off. Need to run. Come on. Go, 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 go! Start taking some shots here at some of this cavalry as they come in. Glorfindel getting stuck in. Let's destroy these this spear unit here. Glorfindel's gonna hold down that wing on his own. I'm gonna gang up on that spear unit with our two units of swordsmen. We're not gonna wait. Let's do this. Let's focus fire on that cavalry right there. Oh no, we're not gonna be able to get out of there in time. Charge! Yeah, now it's getting started. Let's take a quick look here. This is glorious. Nice panoramic shot. Yeah, you can see that a Dunebar Noble unit in the back, they're getting cut up. Oh, maybe they're Shadow Riders. Doesn't matter. They're still cavalry. We need them to die. What are our swords doing? Not so bad. It looks like we lost one of our Elvellan swords, or Elven swords. Glorfindel naturally has eaten these eaten through these spear and horse units, and now he's gone on to desert here in the form of more spear and horse units. How wonderful. Yeah, he's broken them. We're going to start rolling up their lines pretty soon here. Let's take you come this way. Let's try and take these fast-moving archer units here, scoot them around the backs of these Swords of Shadow, try and get some easy hits off on them from the rear. Oh, don't want to get them clipped. They clipped a little bit, that's okay. Time to break these swords here and free up the rest of our units. Those Grim Spears are not long for this world. Time to take some shots at those Swords of Shadow. Like, most of their archers are gone. Yeah, what is left of their army that could be saved is retreating in shame. We'll start to shadow here, trying to chase these guys down. It's not going to go very well for them. These Swords of Shadow here on would be our right flank. They're holding up pretty well. Despite the fact that they're being sandwiched in between two units. Okay, now they're starting to break. Finally. I would have expected that to happen a little bit sooner. Perhaps I've been spoiled with Medieval 2 Total War Cavalry that just destroy anything that they come into contact with. Ah, crap, I keep forgetting to take that off. Come on, Dwarf, now let's go. I'll get it eventually. Someday. Where are our bowmen? Our bow cavalry, hanging out over here. Continue to fire into the rear of those troops. It's a very strange formation here. Our elven spearmen have managed to kind of drive a wedge in between these Grim Spears here, starting to isolate this pocket, which is kind of cool. Alright, time to bring Glorfindel up here and put an end to this battle. You stop that right now. The time has come for these Grim Spears. They are now shaken, but it's going to get so much worse. Crushed, and they're going to rout almost immediately, and then this unit over here is going to follow them very shortly, I'm sure. See, this is one of the things I like that the AI does in Rome 1 that doesn't seem to do in Medieval 2 despite the fact that they share an engine. They will make retreats like this if it appears that they can't win a battle. So these Dunabar units are not actually routing, but they're fleeing the battlefield, which is it's a nice little tidbit. It's very immersive. Okay. So I will see you guys back I'll see you in the casualty screen post battle. But you don't need to watch me do this. By which I mean you don't want to watch a bunch of units just run for the border. Arcalypt the Tall. They didn't take too many of us with them, which is good. Only about 42. I think most of them died against the very doughty Grimspear units up on the hill on our left flank. Noldor Riders doing most of the killing as usual. 650. That's just ridiculous. Glorfindel's going to retire with like an all-time high kill count. Alright, I will see you guys back in the campaign. Victory! Let's see. Looks like the Argalib the Tall managed to retreat. Looks like he's got a little bit of reinforcements here. We're going to take the fight to him immediately. Look at this pathetic collection of mud and sticks. Soon it will be ours, as it is a strategically important pathetic collective of mud and sticks. Alright. One. Two, and Glorfindel, and friends. Alright, looks like they've deployed out in the field, very foolishly, out on the outskirts of town. So we're going to take advantage of this, try and take down that Dunabar Noble Bodyguard ASAP, see if we can't take a bite out of some of these swordsmen and such as well, and just, if we could break these guys out in the field instead of having to fight a bloody stalemate in a choke point somewhere, I'd say that's eminently preferable to an unnecessary waste of elven lives. Oh, it's the Royal Longbowmen! Oh, I hate these guys. I remember what they did to us in the last video. It was terrible. And those spearmen are not going to have a good time. Except for you. Get in there. Yeah, kill those damned longbows. Slaughter them! To bring our swordsmen forward. Destruction! Just the utter annihilation of this army here. I'm gonna bring all these guys forward so they can stop shooting freaking Glorfindel. Except you. You go over here. Yeah, those are the Adunabar nobles that we want. What have we over here? Oh my goodness! Suicidal charge! Two horsemen of the shade. Immediately beginning to rout as he runs into the back of one of these spears and trips and falls over. Poor guy. Destroying these royal spearmen here, the royal longbows are now a thing of the past. Believe. I'm not sure where they went. I guess they charge into melee and now we're eating them as well. Oh, that poor general's bodyguard. What we got up here? So we got some dark bows. Time to start putting some fire into them as well. The general charging in one glorious last stand against the elven bodyguard. Whoop! Lost his horse, unfortunately. Not so glorious. That must be the general right there. It's only a matter of time. Prepare to die! That's right, this is my world. You do not belong in my world! Let's turn you guys off for now. I mean, I guess we could shoot that Shadow Guard unit to death, but where's the fun in that? Let's use Glorfindel. Let's charge into here. Banners flying, war horses whinnying, and elves shouting in their beautiful tongue. Cries to Elvereth to watch over the battle. And let's take this town square. A little footman here. That looks really cool. That's actually a really nice shot. Excuse me while I take a picture of that. Come on. The last stand of these Adunabar cultists. They may be worshippers of the darkness, but hey, you gotta be brave to stand against Glorfindel like this. He's gotta have a reputation at this point. Spears down! Sorry, die you dogs. Speed that up just a tad. Nom nom nom. I'm pretty sure that's all of them. Alright, let's see how we did. Glorfindel getting the most kills. He's like the guy, like if you ever went to an arcade when you were a kid and there's like that one person who has that unbeatable high score that's always there, that's Glorfindel. That's how many orcs he's killed this campaign. Alright, I'll see you guys back on the campaign map. Alright, the mid-deeping is ours. Unfortunately, it's costing us quite a lot of money. And the public order is just awful. Just terrible. Let's have a lot of available able-bodied population. So we can convert this to like a staging ground. Maybe we can make it into like a major settlement later. Let's see, minor province, don't have enough money for that right now, but we do have some elven patronage. If we increase our, it's like your religion, but it's representative of your control in the area, like culturally. If we can increase that, then maybe we can start to take advantage of some of the resources in that city. As for Glorfindel, I think his time is running short, so we're actually going to move him forward and have him, go and attack some armies on his own, do some heroic feats worthy of his name before he slinks back off the Valinor like a tired old man. Alright, Glorfindel taking on the forces of Lieutenant Vardamir. Pretty substantial, all infantry except for those Snaga hunters who are infantry archers, so I suppose that counts. So we're going to run these guys down. It's going to be disgusting. I'll see you guys on the battlefield. Well, that took a lot of work, set out the formation. Alright, let's charge forward. Woo! Kind of put an end to these dark swords here. What do they have in the back? Those are just grim swords. Snaga hunters. Oh, it's gonna be beautiful. Charge! Look at that follow through. Half that unit is already down. Yeah, the Swords of the Shadow here, rushing in to attack us on the flank. I guess we don't really need to cycle charge, but I suppose it'll make things go faster, so let's do that. These grim swords here, out of position, out of formation. Run right through them. Kaboom! Goodbye. Look at that. Brutal, brutal charge. I'm gonna really miss Glorfindel when he's gone. Holy crap. I feel like we could have done more with him. We didn't really need to keep him near an army. I kind of underestimated his strength early in the campaign. Turn up the speed just a little bit. Kaboom! Don't want to get surrounded. Be kind of foolish. Get some distance. Cycle charge back in. Probably winded at this point, that's fine. Kaboom! Run those guys over. Get those snog archers. Boom! Oh man, look at this. Snug Archer's gonna start to run real soon. Here goes their general, and there goes this army. Good job, Glorfindel. You're a hero. A real elven hero. I continue, destroy them all. That was fast. Alright, I'll see you guys back on the campaign map. Boop. Yep, victory indeed. Austin Aglarant. If we could take this, Gondor might have an easier time kind of dealing with the cultist menace, but I don't know if we have time to use him in a siege. Herm. Well, if we siege, they'll probably sally forth and attack us, and we'll be able to run them down in the field. No problem! Let's see here, how close are we getting to having some elven culture here? Shun, Mishmanipane. I don't remember building that. Sentinel posts, don't need that right now. I'm on Lank. What else can we do with you? Okay, so you're going to be done with your market. We should make you... Feasting Hall? No. Gardens of the Golden Light. I've been told, I'm pretty sure that it is these gardens that they are referring to, that the second level of the Gardens of the Golden Light, as well as a building inside of Thranduil's Halls, are very important for increasing your elven population growth rate if you want to continue to recruit elven troops from your settlements, which I do. So we're going to make those next. But yeah, we do have a nice army right now, but we have troubles replenishing it, and once Glorfindel is gone, that's really a huge part of our killing power. We've kind of been, like, coasting along on the coattails of Glorfindel's power. Alright, I'll see you in the next turn. Alright, here we are. Glorfindel laying siege to the town of Ost in Argalad. There's a lot of troops all around right now. I think we're actually just going to assault it. I like that. I like the sounds of that. So we've got two armies here under just regular old lieutenants. Let's see what they're made out of. Yeah, not much there. Not much there. A lot of melee. This is going to be fun. All right, I'll see you guys on the battle map. This will be our last battle for the episode, by the way. All right, here we are. Glorfindel fearlessly taking on this entire town garrison by himself. Let's do this. Yeah, we've got Grim Spears, Axes of the Shadow, Dark Swords, and some Dark Bows. We fear nothing! Forward! Yeah, let's take out these dark bows first. They get behind us and they start shooting us in the back. Even Glorfindel might have some issues. So, yep. I'm gonna veer off right there. Missed me. Mostly. Oh yeah, I should probably take that off too, eh? Kaboom! I'm gonna take these dark bows down real quick. I think they've got some reinforcements coming in as well. We should be able to mop these guys up in the town square and then, be able to meet them in a choke point or something. Alright, we're going to speed this up just a tad. So Glorfindel eat these Grim Spears. Pull back here. Recharge. Boom! Put an end to these spear units quickly and efficiently. We got there, got some Dark Swords. They'll be they're next on our list, and then we'll be winded, and we'll have to take a little bit of time to, we got here, Axes of the Shadow. Oh, no. Don't want to have that happen to us. Flee! Oh, managed to get both of our troops out of there. That's good. Back down into normal time. Get those Grim Spears. Kaboom! Axes of the Shadow. These guys probably have armor piercing, but they don't appear to have shields. We should be able to run them over. But yeah, armor piercing units can be very, very deadly against your heavily armor units. Obviously, they cut your armor rating in half for the purposes of applying wounds and stuff like that. When rolls to hit and wound, etc. Are done by the game's kind of internal clock. Calculator, that's the one. Alright. They are done. Get out! Time to walk, because we are probably very tired at this point. Let's figure out where these guys are exactly. That's a lot of orcs. Looks like they kept them in reserve. Might have some more troops down here. Yeah, so we're going to have to go through here, up this hill, and we're going to walk the whole way. Alright, so we've made it most of the way into the city. Looks like they've brought some Dark Swords here who are now utterly exhausted while we are merely winded. So we are going to carve through these guys like fire in a wheat field. Look at that. Look at them die. So easy. I think we actually lost a couple of Glorfindel's troops here. Oh my goodness, no! Each one a valiant Noldor knight. They will be missed, sort of. They're kind of expendable, actually, in a strange sort of way. Yeah, they're just all gonna run away. That's fine. Oh wow, those troops actually stood and fought. Eat up these dark swords, and we'll probably take a bit of a break. It's hungry work, destroying an entire army on your own. And we've got two units of orcs just huddled in there all together. Like lamb against the wolves. I don't know where the rest of the Zadunamar army is hiding right now. This can't be all of them. I refuse to believe that. Alright. There goes their general. They're going to be fighting in the town square, though, so they are unbreakable, so it does not really matter. We're going to take a quick breather here. Let Glorfindel get back up to fresh, and I'll see you guys in a second. Alright, Glorfindel and company, nice and rested. It's time to do this. Nom 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 nom. Look at this. Just so many orcs here, trapped. There's nowhere for them to go at this point. I don't think there's anything left of that army. Glorfindel's just chewing them up. Holy crap, look at this. Like a hungry amoeba devouring some other protozoa. Nom 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 nom. And that is the end of the Adunabar garrison. We'll end the battle there. 1,400 kills for one unit. Alright, I'll see you guys back on the camp. Alright, we're going to take it and... I guess we'll lay it desolate for now. Why not, right? Sack that city. Lieutenant Varonway and his forces will be next, but that will have to be a battle you guys will have to wait until next time to see. I hope you guys have enjoyed our episode. Things are getting pretty crazy here. Glorfindel off on his own mission while our armies up here hold the pass into Mirkwood. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll see you later. Take care, everybody. Bye-bye.